And without further ado, we are back for the last round here at Road Atlanta. A lot has happened that we need to discuss. Ain't that right, Andrian?
That was a very action-packed couple of races and a very bizarre event at the end of the race where HDT in sixth place just lagged on the finishing line. Not a regular occurrence for anyone with Forza 4 experience, I don't think. If anyone's actually listening to the back chat, if they have that happened to them before, I know it's happened in Toro events right at the start of an opening lobby, maybe mid-race, but I don't think I've ever seen that happen so close to the end of a race.
And unfortunately, we did not catch if there was a contact between them or just HDT's internet died out. He's not in the lobby right now, which is a little...
The bizarre thing is, did he cut out before crossing the line? Therefore, his finishing position doesn't count. Whoever was seventh became sixth.
That we will not know until the lifetime.
Exactly, we're going to have to see the points, which will probably be updated by tomorrow. That is the unfortunate way of things.
Twitch chat has also been very quiet, so no updates yet in regards to what happened.
So that does mean HCR Hamish is on pole for the final race, along with Plough Tubby. And we've got the Cobalts locking up the second row. The Cobra King and King Cobra. Is that the Camber King and King Cobra?
Yes.
Bottle, glass, glass, bottle. Just like that.
And then we have Jabberwockies and Slider, followed by Mystic and Player Asleep, Belmond and Akihiro-san, TJ Steele, and Solar Flare. So we'll be seeing six rows instead of seven tonight. And I believe they're not going to do a warm-up lap. They're just going to go as soon as the countdown reaches zero. Granted, if they remember to change the lap counter to seven.
That does mean knocking the laps down to seven if it's going to be a standing start direct from the get-go.
Of course, we'll have to see what happens. Definitely a lot of action during round two for the mid-pack at the beginning of the first two laps, and they did a great job avoiding a massive pile-up.
Yeah, that's... I mean, the typical touring car standard is to be double-wide going into turns, and the notorious S-Bend section of Road Atlanta, which you don't see very often... I mean, you'll see it with overlapping in the All-American Le Mans series or the couple of times Grand Am have been there. But for touring cars around there, it's in real life. I mean, you can obviously guide me to a YouTube thread to correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think I've ever seen that happen.
Well, I can't really provide any information to assess that.
Bless you. I was trying to hold that one back. I was trying to find the mute button. Unfortunately, I was too late.
No, you hit the mute button, and then as you sneeze, you unmuted.
I hope I didn't deafen anybody.
I'd be more concerned about myself.
Oh, dear.
It's okay.
Hashtag blame JV.
Hey, here's an old one for you, Adrian. Hashtag fish position.
Oh, God. That's one of Simon's.
Yep, and
that's definitely one of Simon's.
Oh, I remember during one of his live streams, someone brought up, "Are you going to say fish position?" And his response was, "No,
no,
no."
No.
Well, there's also Vet Fest.
By the way, S-Big's doing a rather splendid job of doing a online live stream along with everyone else that does a PC live stream. Now he's mostly Daisy and the Armor. Mods. Very popular indeed now. Good luck to him.
Well, speaking of live streaming, it's still early to announce this. However, there is talks of doing a day one live stream for Project Cars on the Xbox One.
Well, we did one for Forza 5.
Well, it's not going to be 24 hours.
Yeah, that wasn't really, it was like 1 hour of disappointment followed by 23 of, oh, look at this.
I know that Technologic Mouse, who is one of our new media team members, is volunteering to do a good brunt of the live streaming once he gets his Hapog capture card in the mail. And I kind of brought up the idea of, well, why don't we do something special? I can't really delve too much into the details until things are finalized and we get some able-bodied folks. Maybe we'll see some special guests. Maybe, who knows?
Yeah, like I said, PS4 for me at the moment, so it's a complete no-no as far as live streaming goes. Back to the racing, we've got HDT back in the lobby, so he's explaining his case to the rest of the field. Very odd occurrence, but he's back in the lobby, hopefully to get a clean bill of health for the final race. He will be, unfortunately, at the back of the pack, unless they're going to do the warm-up lap again to put him back into where his results from the previous two races.
Were.
Yes, which means he'd be in midfield somewhere like that, unless he has to start from the back of the pack.
Really, yeah, it's gonna be hard to say. We're just waiting for Akihiro-san to get back before we can start, so
Yeah.
who knows, maybe we'll see one more final warm-up lap here.
Was Akihiro side of the yeah he was. He was in the sort of Loctite livery-esque Integra with the Loctite then on it. Hull to corner 71.95. Apparently there's Indy cars tonight from Xbox One. I'm assuming you don't have that yet, Stephen.
I do have Forza 5. Unfortunately, I would not be participating in. Again, there would be no way for us to do a pre-recorded live
Oh
stream.
yes, of course we can't. Thanks, Turn 10, for not letting us be live streaming on Forza 5. Let's move swiftly on. I completely forgot about that.
And also, thank you, Turn 10, for limiting the replay data to be only 30 minutes. Because the best
As
racing
always.
happens after 30 minutes.
I don't know, mind you've seen our Toro GT footage from the past.
And also, I know that folks who try to live stream tour events on the Xbox One, it is strongly recommended to use the capture card instead of the Twitch app that is known for lagging up the lobbies really bad.
That they did not think that one through, did they?
It was a rushed product. Maybe Forza 6 will rectify a lot of things. Actually, since Project Cars did get delayed till April, some people are kind of wanting to hear more about Forza 6 content, which we don't have at this time.
I don't think anything's been announced from 4 to 6 other than the Ford GT.
And I think a few other things going on behind the scenes, but mostly just about the new Ford GT. And surprisingly, I didn't think it's been already 2 years since Forza 5 came out.
Yeah, it's not gonna be, it's not memorable, is it?
No, it doesn't feel like it's been 2 years.
But it has been 4 years with Forza 4.
And look where we are now,
And
still
still
going.
going strong-ish.
Hey, if there was spectate mode for Forza 5, you would definitely be seeing a lot
If
of live
I had
coverage.
wings, if my gran had wheels, she'd be a bicycle. That's sort of, it doesn't matter anymore. We're going to be hopefully moving on to better things with Andy Tudor and Project Cars.
I'm definitely looking forward to seeing what the multiplayer has to offer.
To be fair, we pinned a lot of hopes on Forza 5. We were disappointed. I think we're not going to be disappointed with Project Cars. Despite various minor flaws, we're not going to be disappointed.
Right. And it's a good thing that they are doing some additional tweaks and inputting a few more
Another couple of
updates.
weeks to put more tweaks.
Couple of weeks for your tweaks. Yeah. Ooh.
Just a reminder then, Stephen, is the grid order you see on the screen now, is that apart from HDT at the back, that is your running order for the last race. as we close in on 10 minutes to midnight UK time.
I'm going to assume that this will be the final running order. Then again, things end up changing.
It still baffles me, though, that there's three Honda CRZs in here and the Saab 9.3 Aero.
And don't forget the Kia Forte.
There's the Kia, Forte. The Kia Forte, though, that was a front runner a couple of times, especially in the North American Touring Car Championship that we were in a couple of years ago. But the weight of those CRZs and the Saabs immediately suggests that they are complete no-go areas. Have some of you found, unlocked a particular modification that like makes it go X amount quicker? I mean, Plough Tubby will have to sort of interrogate him at one point, because he is the tuning. Plough are pretty good at their tuning. If it's a secret, then fine by me. If it's not a secret, I mean, fair enough. It's easily accessible on Forza 4. Someone will find that through the modifications on the game. They've done a splendid job with that car, nonetheless.
So, any thoughts in regards to Forza 6, even though we have nothing to really go on?
What do you mean, me? I haven't been keeping an eye since the disappointment of Forza 5, unfortunately.
Well, hopefully we have a bigger roster, because there were some events that, unfortunately, we couldn't do on Forza 5, like Test Car. Can't really do much with German touring cars, unfortunately.
You mean the Audi and the Mercedes? I mean, as long as you block them off without any mods, that's fine. You can't really involve the old Astra, because that's the car that ran at the Nürburgring 24 hours, which was completely unlimited and restricted compared to the DTM model. And that thing will end up caning the rest of the field.
Sorry, I just have a little bit of a migraine right now. I think my cereal's coming back on me.
Oh, dear.
I heard me Lucky Charms, and it bit
back. Okay, we're still waiting on Akihiro-san to... By the way, you didn't have a headset, if I remember, in Mugello.
Well, actually, Akihiro-san just... I think he was in party chat or something, because he is back.
Ah, fair enough, then.
And someone by the name of TauntSquash49 has joined the lobby. I don't... Okay,
that's
he's gone.
Very odd.
He's gone.
Who put it on public? Who put this lobby on public? That's not right.
I think the bigger question is, who allowed a friend to hop in?
No way.
Well, it actually did happen during the Sebring. I think it was round 6. One of my friends hopped into the lobby.
It has happened. It's happened. Not me, but I think I was in the middle of a lobby and someone just sort of turned up at random and went, "Hey, everybody!" And then it disappeared.
I hate people like
swiftly.
That. All right, so we finally can get started with the third round. Banter time is over. Commentary time is on.
Torah time.
Every day is Torah time.
Except Monday morning when it's like, no.
No, sometimes it has to be Torah time on Monday. You don't like to have to do it on Monday mornings. I also want to point out, I don't know if I'm going to be doing photography for the Touring Cup cars, and I think they are doing a running grid thingamajig.
Yeah, they're going to have to. They're going to get HDT back into grid position if that's the case.
All right, so then we'll wait once again until they hit up turn 4 to start the grid again.
But it will be Hamish on pole, followed by Plough Tubby.
Well, actually, change of plans. We have a new person on pole.
What? Okay.
Yeah, I don't think the lobby points were officially final. All right, so they're making their way through turn 4. Without further ado, the starting grid here at Road Atlanta. when the music actually kicks in, of course. Alright, so for some reason, on the pole will be Solar Flare, and next to him will be TJ Steel. Row 2 is going to have Akihiro-san, followed by HCR Bulma. In Row 3, we have HCR Mystic, followed by Player Asleep. I'm surprised he's still awake this time. In Row 4, we have Slider S15.
Stop it.
I'm sorry. next will be Jabberwockies 1. In Row 5, we have the King Cobra with Camera King. And in Row 6, we have
So that would suggest then that his disappearance from race 2 meant that he was a non-finisher, despite almost being an nth of a meter away from the finish line.
And it's going to be another standing start.
Yeah, that would be the norm for touring cars.
Alright, so we're going to go on board with Akihiro-san.
Yeah, that livery, coming back to it, if you look at it properly, resembles a Honda NSX from the All Japan GT from something like 2003, 2004. It was originally the Castrol Mugen car before Loctite took over the sponsorship. Obviously, he's honouring the livery, but decided to get rid of the decals altogether.
And green flag is out, and so begins the final round at Road Atlanta. Akihiro-san's going to be coming through the middle in third place with TJ Steel and Solar Flare on opposite sides. Three wide coming into turn one, and Akihiro-san's going to hold his line. All three drivers hold their line perfectly through turn one. Akihiro-san's going to get the lead with Solar Flare in second place. And TJ Steel's right up there in third with him, followed by Belmont. Alright, so once again, awesome entertainment in middle to top of the pack.
Almost at the start, the midfield squashed its way through turn one, and they're going to be side by side through the S's.
And Akihiro-san went off the track a little bit, exiting out of turn five. However, he's still holding his line up against Solar Flare, who's still holding into second place. And it looks like some battles are going on mid-pack, as we see one of the Honda Zeds just go off the track there. I think that was Plow Tubby.
Noticing a little bit of lag. They are going to be very close. I think we're going to see some... That grid order was very jumbled, it seemed, and there's going to be a bit of chaos theory going through these next couple of laps before they ease off after the halfway point, just to spread out a little bit more.
And they battle for third. It looks like Belmont's going to try to get it back from TJ Steel. Solar Flare has gained the lead from Akihiro-san. And a lot is going on between fourth place. We're going to go quickly on board with Jabberwockies, as he is right now in the back of this chaos. It's going to be between Belmont and TJ Steel for third place.
Impressive work by the Saab to still be close to the action.
Alright, Solar Flare is starting to pull away from second place. And Belmont is still right up there with TJ Steel. As both cars exit out of turn 5, Steel is going to slow down and Belmont's going to keep up in the draft.
A lot of dust being kicked up. This isn't a rallycross event, as far as dust is concerned.
Alright, once again going back to Jabberwockies, as both teammates, Belmont and Mystic, are now battling it out for fourth place.
They've been very closely matched through these through the three races we've seen today.
Looks like Jabberwockies is going to be drafting off of Mystic, however Belmont seems to have the acceleration to keep up with him.
Completing a crocodile from fourth to last in the lobby.
And we see Plow Tubby and his team going at it in the middle of the pack. And Jabberwockies makes the move. Jabberwockies has now moved up to fifth place and is holding his own. And almost some contact there with Haiti T. Jabberwockies is going to hold the inside line coming into turn one, starting to push Mystic to the side there. You see King Cobra and Belmont also caught up in the mix as well.
And they're still side by side after the first three laps.
All right. It's shifted now between King Cobra and Belmont for sixth and fifth. And we see the cars just being pushed to the side going through turn three.
Oh, three wide going up to the top of the hill here. That's not going to...
Still yeah, side by side coming into turn five.
And how the hell are they able to race? Oh, they're not too bad. They weren't too bad going through the S's. But that backstretch is going to be a complete and utter traffic jam.
Well, speaking of the backstretch, we see a three-way battle here. It's going to be between Haiti, Hamish, and I believe Player Asleep. Oh, they've now sorted out coming down the back straightaway. ADT is now left out to dry.
Very close at the back.
Oh, looks like one of those Sabs has tried to make the pass and is slowed down going through turn 10. Yeah, Hamish is holding his line.
That's the weight of that thing. As it tries to get to top speed. Whereas the other guys are going to get there quicker.
Alright, quick run through. Whoa, I think I just saw some lag there. I don't know who that...
Yeah,
whoa.
You did.
No, I think someone just spun out.
Yeah.
That is... ADT. ADT is slowing down. And there goes his
maybe
car.
Maybe that is connection.
ADT has just dropped from the lobby.
Yeah, you could... There was a live race a couple of years ago where you saw ADT had Dan going through a Stowe Corner at Silverstone, where he just continued along the trajectory of Stowe Corner, off the track and into the inside wall. That's essentially the same thing that happened there to Haiti T. Mid-race disappearance. It's going to happen, unfortunately. He's going to be very disappointed with his run this weekend.
All right, going back to Jabberwockies, we have Belmond, King Cobra, Hamish, Plowtubby, and Camber King all lined up. So this is from fifth back.
Yeah. Now, thanks to the disappearance of ADT, the unfortunate disappearance of ADT, the crocodile is beginning to disperse somewhat. That Saab is still doing the biz in the top five. It's one of the Integras. I do apologize.
And we have a battle from 7th to 10th. It looks like King Cobra is going to try to make the move on Belmont coming up towards turn one, and King Cobra gets the line. Almost four wide exiting out of turn one. Very nice, guys. They're probably going to ask if I got that, and I'm going to say, yes, I did. I did.
Oh, you did.
On board with our lobby host, Belmont. Through the,
you're going to see the replay. That is a picture. If save the replay.
Unfortunately, I will not be able to.
If they're listening to me right now, which I'm assuming they're not, they're going to be saving the replay. That's going to be a wallpaper for anyone online.
Probably the best photo of the moment.
One of the best wallpapers of 2015, and it's only February.
And they are still going at it. The pack from 7th to 11th now.
Cobalt off wide after the S's. Blimey. It's amazing work from the guys to be not even... I mean, they're going to be hitting each other on accident, but they are racing as hard and as easy as they can, really, side by side around here.
And going through
is not
10,
an easy job.
Like, oh, sorry, Slider has just lost the position to Plowtubby, or I just spoke too soon. They're still going side by side coming down through turn 11. And it looks like Slider's going to hold the inside line, exiting out of turn 12. Still keeping up with Plowtubby on the front straightaway. Two laps to go here.
I think that was a classic example of overlap on the exit of the final chicane. Slider, very experienced driver, same with Plautabby. They're not going to, I mean, if they do have exactly the same setup, they might not have the exact same driving style. But to keep close like that, very, very good work indeed, despite them being at the back of the Lobby A field.
As for the front, not much has changed. Solar Flare is all by his lonesome, as Akihiro-san is now exiting out of turn 6. We're going to quickly go back to the action mid-pack. Jabberwockies has caught up to Mystic. And TJ Steele is trying to hold on to third place the best that he can, with 1.5 laps to go. Mystic is right now breathing down on him. TJ Steele is going to go to the left side, and Mystic is going to stick to the right inside line. However, TJ Steele has the acceleration coming down through turn 9. He's going to hold it. And Jabberwockies is just trying to figure out who to draft off of. Maybe see both of them wreck.
Last lap coming up. Still close battling in the midfield.
Alright, white flag is out. One lap to go for Solar Flare. You're now focusing on third and fourth place between Mystic and TJ Steele. This is going to be for third, side-by-side, crossing the star finish line. TJ Steele still has the acceleration. He's going to hold the outside line going to turn one, and Mystic is going to make the move and cross him, exiting out of turn one. Very nice move by Mystic. Very clean. Mystic has no one in front of him, and TJ Steele is now going to have to contend with Jabberwockies for fourth place. He's got to put on a defensive line if he wants to hold on to the top five position. However, Steele goes wide, and Jabberwockies is going to hold the inside line, exiting out of turn 5. Steele has now dropped to 5th, and behind Steele is going to be Hamish. Hamish is going to be side-by-side with Steele coming up into turn 6. Steele goes wide, and Hamish is going to get the position away from Steele. Steele has now dropped to 6th place, and behind them will be Belmond. Not looking good for Steele. And we're just going to cut away for a moment as we see Solar Flare coming down the back straightaway, coming into turn 10. Coming through turn 10A and 10B, up the hill towards turn 11. Checker flag is going to be waving as Solar Flare comes down through turn 11, entering turn 12, and he's going to take the win here for round 3. Second place is going to go to Akihiro-san. Third is going to go to Mystic. And then behind them, a fleet of cars. It's going to be Jabberwockies, followed by Hamish and Steele. And a wreck as they cross the star finish line.
Oh, dear.
It was after the star finish line, so I do not think it
Yeah, that does... Yeah, unfortunately, that's the automated driver kicking in as they cross the finish line. So, I think someone's done some celebration after the line and... Maybe cause that. But once you've crossed the finish line in a 4-4 game, you are not in control in any way possible. So that's an unfortunate side effect.
Warning, may cause cancer.
Not right. That bad.
Okay. Sure.
I think you've gone a bit too far there, Steve-O.
I am never too far. All right, so we have a few more minutes before we close the stream with some... closing post-race thoughts. So, Adrian, you've been gone for a long time. How's it feel coming back into the comms booth?
Almost like a glove, worryingly. It's been a while since we've done any kind of... I've done any kind of live streaming, and it's just... it's almost like I never left. It was the same with the podcasts on Downforce. The banter is still there. It's the driver... Gamer tags possibly have changed, but the formula that we've seen over the last few races is still wonderful. It still works. You still get your kind of inevitable contact, whether it's deliberate or not. Maybe you'll see that with the stewards, if there is any stewards in the Toro Community Championships.
Oh, there probably will be.
Maybe lower down the action you've seen Lobby A, we may not see it live streamed, but the lower lobbies will have had just as much fun as the guys in Lobby A. You could tell that from the guys that were going side by side through the most awkward parts of the Road Atlanta track, and that's the majority of the circuit there. It's very, very narrow, especially for two cars, especially for one car, really.
Well, I'll just end with my closing thoughts. Compared to what happened at Mugello, this was the best I've seen so far on a Friday. Definitely a lot of action mid-pack. A lot of action. Saw some 3 and 4 wide action going on through the turns and the straights.
Yeah, that 4 wide. If anyone has saved the replay, I would recommend you go to the moment where it was from 3rd to 6th were 4 wide on the exit of 2 and 1 halfway through race 3, and getting a good shot of that to be used as a wallpaper. That is an amazing shot that we might have missed for all eternity if you haven't saved that replay.
Well, I'm sure there will be some folks who save some lobby A replay footage. Just fumbling over my words. All right, folks, unfortunately, we've run out of time for tonight or this evening, depending on where you live.
We're about 10 minutes late, actually. we were on queue to be finishing before midnight.
Well, that's perfectly fine. We're going to be seeing a lot of wait time here and there. Well, Adrian, thank you for joining me in the comms booth. It was definitely a treat to have you again.
Thanks very much, Steve. I think I owe you another one.
Well, we'll see what happens next Friday, depending on my work schedule. Who knows? We might have more people. We'll see. Alrighty, so without further ado, take care, everybody. See you soon.
Good racing, everyone.